a part of a new ministry. Some of them look, because I was very thin. And handsome, though. You can see I'm handsome.
I knew it was the right time to stars. And it was in February. Now, then we didn't have instruments. A certain man, you see him on November. He's when they are in Venda, he's that doctor. He wears some this. You see that man? He was staying in Hamani. So I went to visit him, and he said to me, "You see, I'm relocating. I'm going to Joburg, and now these are the instruments and the things. I don't need them anymore. Everything that is a thing." But to be received. Surely goodness and mercy. Why are you following it? If God called you, He knows how to do it. He will help you. But if you're doing it on your own, using your own things, something is wrong somewhere. I get what I'm saying. There are many testimonies I can give, but it's because I want to talk about marriage. Hallelujah. And that's how the church started. We started like that, the church grew, until today is one of the big churches around. We do big conferences, we've invited powerful people like Benjamin Dube, Solima Kambu. Those are friends, they're people I talk to. We have so many, you can name Apostle Ben Dove if you know great men of God. Bishop Isaac Ntumkulu, if you know great men of God. We invite all of those great men of God. Even the man of God who comes here more often, Bishop Mirubi, he's actually a friend of mine. He came there, he preached. Many people came there and saw. Why? Because we followed the Spirit. We did things according to the way of God. I get it. But let me tell you what the key is. Marriage. If you do it right and you get married to the right person, everything opens up. Are you there? Let's get into it. Because I came here to help some people. There are certain people who are chosen by God, and God is so serious with you that He sent me. Let me tell you this. I said that I was never going to tell you. But let me tell you. I came here 5 years ago. The people who were here, the committee, they did not know how to honor the servants of God. The way they treated us, they didn't treat me the way I thought they should treat us. Because if a celebrity comes here, you will take serious care of him. Yeah? And sometimes when men of God come here to preach, and even after the service, you just give them other side control, you say, "Men of God is fine." Then the next week you bring Benjamin to me and give him 30,000. God is blessing you with great men. When people like Apostle Midupi, when he comes in our church, I make sure I take good care of him. He's not an ordinary man. He's a great man. He deserves some respect and honor. Not only him, everybody you invite, take good care of them. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm not poor, eh? God is taking good care of me. And I'm not looking for money when I preach. Huh? I'm not looking for money. I don't owe anyone anything. I buy my things cash. Oh, yes. So, I'm not poor. But I want to say, when you honor servants of God, you bring blessings upon your life. Amen. I'm just glad when I came here, I came to the right people. I see how you really receive me, how you really take good care of me. When I arrive here, I'm not complaining. You are better than those 5 years ago. Amen. You know why I'm saying this? Because some of you don't have an idea. Some of you are going to be great men and women of God. That's why today I'm going to touch sensitive things. I'm going to touch things. You know, with me, you can be sure, I'll tell you things no one can tell you. Because everybody in life, you need that person. You know that person who is not afraid of you. You know that person who will tell you. Because they know they're going. You know that person. Yeah. Amen. Not because I'm going, I'm just like that. Amen. That is why God called me. I'm not a coward. I say things as they are. But listen to this. Are you there? Are you there?
Yes.
Some of you are going to become powerful ministers of the gospel. You will have mega churches. Mega. Not scalapalanga churches that we see today. I'm talking about mega churches. Big churches that will make an impact. I don't preach to ordinary people. No. I preach to people who are called by God. I preach to people who have a special assignment. That's why I'm very strong when I talk to people. Because God is very serious with it. Amen. That's why we want to talk. If you get it wrong, when it comes to marriage, then you're in trouble. Because we don't want ministers who are divorcing. Are you hearing me? Hello? Many people divorce because they take light, you know, the marriage issues. These are important things. You get it wrong, you're gone. Even the ministry will just crash because of marriage. That's why you have to marry the right one. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's talk about Genesis chapter 2. We have to talk about it because this is where marriage started. Amen. We're gonna put it in a good way. I know I'm talking to some people right here. I'm talking to people who love God. I'm talking to people who want to do it right. There are those who don't care. As long as they are married and their friends are happy for them, I am happy. It's bigger than you being happy. It's you functioning. It's you doing a purpose of being in line with God's purpose and plan for you. After all, this world is not our home. We are passing through. You think you're going to live here forever? You're going to die someday. And when you die, God will ask you, what have you done for me while you were still in the earth? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Somebody has to say amen to that.
Yes.
Somebody say amen to that.
Yes.
Are you with me? Are you with me? Yes. Now listen. Genesis 2. We read verse. Because I want to touch something very important. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Look at verse 15. And the Lord God took, let's stand because it's the opening scripture. And the Lord God took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat it, but of the tree of knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. And the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him and have meat for him. And out of the ground of the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all cattle and so forth and so forth. Thank you, God. Bless you. Who created marriage? Who started marriage? Who started marriage? Who started marriage? So, God knows marriage better than any of us. If we want marriage, we must learn from Him. Okay? We must learn from Him. So, He created Adam. And firstly, look at it. Before marriage was there, God made sure that he creates a man, he has a relationship with the man, and this man knows God, this man understands God. I hear what I'm saying. In other words, marriage is not for everyone. Marriage is for people who know God, people who understand God, people who know the God's purpose for their life in as far as spiritual things are concerned. Do you understand? One day we will meet him.
meet him. One day we will meet him.
And we want to make sure that we do our part.
So marriage is for people who know God.
You see, if you see somebody and they are very old and they are not married yet, don't trample them. Hey, you are old. Who told you they are old? They're still trying to learn and find God. Don't rush them. Because if they don't know God, they can't get into marriage. They won't understand marriage. Marriage is big. You see, the people of the world, they know nothing about marriage. That's why divorce actually started with them. And now they're trying to bring it into the church. And they make it look like it's nothing. Divorce. People who divorce, they will go to hell. And I've got scriptural background. And some of you, you call yourselves Christian, but you're still eyeing that man. He divorced, and then you say, now, you know a certain young lady there? She attended a big church there. She came to me, she said, man of God, I want to see you. It was midweek. She came there. And then she said, man of God, I've got a problem. I went to Pretoria. A certain prophet, beware of the false prophets. A certain man is a prophet, said to me, you see, I can see your husband. There is a man, he didn't call him by name. He said, I see a man, his name is 123. He's married with the wrong person. And now they're going to divorce, and he's your husband. He's actually your husband.
Like the way the other prophets are doing, but he's there.